We shall be seeing the anatomy of lower leg for free fibula flap harvesting. So suppose this is the outline of the lower leg. This is the fibula, and this is the tibia. Okay, so between the fibula and the tibia, you have a interosseous membrane. This interosseous membrane divides the lower leg into two compartments, the anterior compartment and the posterior compartment. Again, there is a lateral compartment. The boundaries are anterior intramuscular septum and the posterior intramuscular septum. So this is the anterior compartment, the posterior compartment, and the lateral compartment. The posterior compartment is again divided into two parts, that is deep part. This is the deep part and this is the superficial part. So now let us see the muscles of each compartment and other contents. So in the anterior compartment, you have the extensors and anterior tibialis muscle. The extensors are attached on the medial surface of the fibula. So you have the extensor digitorum longus muscle, and also you have the extensor hallucis longus muscle here. This is the extensor hallucis longus muscle, plus you have the tibialis anterior muscle. So this is the tibialis anterior muscle. You have extensor digitorum longus muscle. You have extensor hallucis longus muscle. And between the extensors and the tibial this tibialis anterior muscle, you have the anterior tibial artery and the vein. Okay, so this is all about anterior compartment. In the posterior compartment, just below the interosseous septum, just below the interosseous membrane, you have the tibialis posterior muscle. So this is the tibialis posterior muscle. Okay, below the tibialis posterior muscle lies the flexor hallucis longus muscle, somewhat like this. This is the tibialis posterior muscle and this is the flexor hallucis longus muscle. Between these two muscles, you will find the peroneal artery and the respective vena comitens for peroneal artery. And then another muscle you have here is flexor digitorum longus muscle. This is the flexor digitorum longus muscle, and here you can find the posterior tibial artery and vein. Okay, so this is all about deep part of the posterior compartment. This is the deep part of the posterior compartment. And now this in the superficial part of the posterior compartment, you have got two muscles. One is the big soleus muscle like this, and other one is the gastrocnemius muscle. So this is the soleus muscle, this is the gastrocnemius muscle. And now coming to the lateral compartment, in the lateral compartment you have got two muscles, that is the, you have got peroneus brevis and peroneus longus muscles. Okay, so this is all about the muscles and arteries. Okay, so let us revise the anatomy once again. This is the fibula. This is the tibia. This is the interosseous membrane joining these two bones. And this is all the anterior compartment. Okay, so this is anterior compartment. In anterior compartment, you have got the muscles we have are the extensor digitorum longus muscle, then extensor hallucis longus muscle. We have tibialis anterior muscle, then we have the anterior tibial artery and veins. Now coming to the posterior compartment. So this is the posterior compartment. In the posterior compartment, it is again divided into two parts, the superficial. This is the superficial part and the deep part. And in the deep part, you have the first muscle which is there is the tibialis posterior muscle, attached on the medial surface of the fibula here, and here in the upper part above the attachment of the interosseous membrane, you have the extensors attached there. And between the tibialis posterior and flexor hallucis longus, this is the flexor hallucis longus muscle, you have the peroneal artery and vein. Peroneal artery and vein, they are the part, this is the peroneal artery and the veins, these are the these are divisions from posterior tibial artery and vein. These are the posterior tibial artery and vein, and this is the flexor digitorum longus muscle. And in the superficial part, you have the soleus muscle. This is the soleus muscle. And the soleus muscle is sometimes used in the harvesting of the free fibula flap. And this is the gastrocnemius muscle. This is the gastrocnemius muscle. In the lateral compartment, we have the peroneus brevis muscle and the peroneus longus muscle. Now let us see how the pedicle is oriented, how the flap is harvested. So we shall see that. We can see that this is the peroneal artery and vein which we need for survival of our skin paddle. Suppose this is the outer skin paddle. Okay, so this is the posterior septum. Okay, so we want what happens is the perforators from this artery comes in the septum and supply the skin, overlying skin. Okay, they come like this and supply the overlying skin. So we need to harvest the entire thing, the septum along with the perforators and the pedicle. So somehow we need to harvest the fibula. Suppose this is the fibula along with this much pedicle and the perforators and the skin paddle like this much. So this much part is taken out for the free fibula flap.